It's Ron, welcome back to Dark Souls. So last time, we took out the four kings of Nulanda ruins, then we made our way to the catacombs, and then frankly, I jumped to my death in comical fashion, because damn it, it's what I do. So anyway, usually there's an NPC by this lever called Patches, however, I noticed some kind of criteria to make him disappear. I think it's got something to do with a chick back in Firelink Shrine and her compadres. I think it's something along the lines of if they've already left by the time you come here, then Patches isn't at the lever, or the other way around, I'm not entirely sure, but yes. Be aware, if Patches is here, the first time you try and cross this bridge, he will rotate it back again and try and kill you, because Patches, frankly, bit of a dick. Can't stand that guy. That's right, come here, buddy, jump attack. Oh god, I love this club so damn much. You have no idea. It's ridiculous. Yoink. Okay, so anyway, over here there is a very poorly hidden secret, because that is a developer message. I cannot believe that worked. It was freaking badass. Like I say a million times, I really hate the messages on the ground, especially when they're left by the developers. It ruins the whole point of a secret to me. I really, really don't get it, but whatever, I guess nobody can find the damn thing. So, we are about to get the Dark Moon Seance Ring. You may remember all the way back in Anolondo, I said when you want to fight Gwyndolin, if you haven't killed Guinevere, you actually have to equip this ring, and then next to his boss Vog, the statue will disappear, then you can go in, join his covenant, or fight him, whatever the hell you want to do. But, yeah, if you kill Guinevere, then, you know, you can just go and fight the guy right away. However, killing Guinevere, as you noticed, makes Anolondo dark. Killing Gwyndolin, however, does not. Not entirely sure why. Will you stop shooting me, you skeleton dicks? I think I've just come up the wrong ladder. Yes! Yes, I have! Goddamn it, brain. What the hell are you doing today? Ouch! Do you mind? I'm just trying to climb a ladder. Jesus Christ, you inconsiderate skeleton dick. Oh my god! It's so damn irritating! I think if you have poise, it won't stagger you on the ladder like it is doing to me. Not entirely sure, but I think that's the case if I'm remembering correctly. Okay, let's get the hell out of here. You may notice I chug my Estus all the goddamn time. There's a good reason for that. It's because in Dark Souls, you get hit very, very hard. So really, you want to be as close to maximum HP as you possibly can, as often as you possibly can. So even though I'm wasting a little bit of Estus every time I do it, as long as it keeps me alive, that's what really matters. You know, there's no point having them if you don't get a chance to use them because you just get one shot because you let your HP get too low. So yeah, that's my advice. Drink it all the damn time. I do not trust that skull over there. That guy is very, very suspicious. Oh, by the way, I looked those guys up because I was wondering what the hell their official name was. Apparently, they're called Wisps, so there you go. So anyway, in here, this is where you can join Nito's Covenant. However, if he's dead before you try and join it, you can't join the damn thing. However, I believe you can kill him after joining the Covenant, and then I don't think you get kicked out, but you can't rank up in it, because to rank up in the Covenant, you have to donate him Eyes of Death, and if he's dead, then you can't do that, you know, kind of a problem. Now, however, if you want to join the Covenant, you need at least one Eye of Death in your inventory. Luckily, there's three in here right behind this Tyrant Demon body, but still, you have to get to them alive, which, unless you're a mage, is going to be kind of dangerous, because this guy, just like the rest of them, hits like a freaking truck. Here we go. Get out of here, you Tyrant Demon bastard. Okay, give me those Eyes of Death. Yoink. Okay, let's go join the damn Covenant. We may as well, and then we'll murder him in cold blood just for the hell of it. You do get a really good sword for joining it. It's kind of awesome. Anyway, so, just like the crow's nest, you have to wait here about 20 seconds. Again, gotta remember, you need at least one Eye of Death, otherwise this ain't gonna work. Then eventually, a cutscene will trigger. There we go, and now we are in Nito's boss room, and yes, you can run up to him and join his freaking covenant, and he doesn't attack you. Don't know exactly what the hell's up with that. I mean, when you come here later, he jumps you straight away, but, whatever. And no, you can't attack him, I tried. Okay, let's join the damn thing, shall we? I'm trying to remember what the hell the thing's called. I think it's called the Gravelord Sword, and I think you get a miracle as well. Yes, that sword, really cool. It's the only sword in fact, the only weapon in the entire game which actually has toxic on it. God, it looks freaking badass as well. Okay, we got our shit. Let's get the hell out of here. And just like I mentioned, if you want to rank up in this covenant, he has to be alive. You come back here, you pray to the crotch, and then you donate him Eyes of Death. If you want to farm them, you can either, I think you get them for doing something to do with the Gravelord Covenant, which is the one we just joined, or you can farm them from the Basilisk buddies in the depths, or in the tree, but I would go to the depths. And they drop them fairly commonly if you have max drop rates, so that's probably the best place to get them. Coffin travel. I sense the only way to travel. Travel in style with coffin travel. Okay, where the hell are we going? How'd this guy die? I'm guessing the Turnout Demon. Okay, don't know what the hell happened to him. God, I love the bloodstains. They are freaking amazing. Okay, there's gonna be a bunch of skeletons down here. Plunging attack. Yeah. And see that coming, did you? Oh, shit. Okay, I am really bad at parrying the skeletons, apparently. Jesus. He's almost made me bleed. Well, not really. He's like half made me bleed. Oh, shit. Okay, I knew that was gonna give away, but I didn't know I was that damn close to it. Okay, let's try this again. You know what's great? Let's just go for the freaking backstab. Or, whatever, we'll just crush you with a club. Okay. Now, I am probably about to die here, because we have Bonewheel skeletons coming up. Bonewheel is ready? Yes, they are freaking ready. Those things kick the crap out of me. I know how to deal with them, but there's so damn many of them, I always just get overwhelmed and die. So, yeah, I may very well die here. Frankly, I expect it. And that over there, I believe that is our last necromancer, so, yeah, we are just gonna bum-rush these guys. Don't shoot me, there we go. Okay, problem solved. Let's get rid of the skeleton buddies. Okay, so like I say, skeleton bonewheel thingamajigs out here, and these guys, incredibly dangerous. So dangerous, in fact, that I'm gonna change my weapon so we can kill them quicker. And once we're at it, we're gonna put on a better sword, because essentially they'll roll at you in their bonewheel thingamajigs. And it would destroy your stamina. If you have a half-decent shield, you can block through it, but, still, it takes off a lot of freaking stamina, and if you don't block it, it will tear you to pieces incredibly quickly. And we're gonna go with a wolf ring, because I don't want to get staggered by them. Where the hell did you come from? Okay, that was very strange. Whatever. Anyway, there's also a black knight around here, and some floating skulls, so, yeah. There's a lot of shit going on in this section. This, oh, da-da-da-da. Okay. That's what I mean. You turn your back to them, they can destroy you incredibly quickly. We really need to get rid of these wisps right now. Blow up. Blow up, goddammit. Okay, run. This is where this section gets incredibly dangerous, because if I turn my back on a bonewheel skeleton, you'll see a da-da-da-da. They try and do that, and they will tear you to pieces and shit. The Black Knights come down. Oh, crap! Okay. This is not good. This guy, just like the rest of the Black Knights in the game, except the ones in the kiln, will not respawn, and usually he doesn't drop down. This kind of, you may remember where I broke the ground up above, and you can drop down. You can drop down next to him and then go and kill him, but sometimes, as you've seen, he will drop down on you, so, yeah, that's the thing. Either way, he's dead. We are still alive, and I see a bunch more Bonewheel skeletons over there. Good lord, I hate this section so damn much. It scares the crap out of me. I remember the very first time I came here, I accidentally found Vamos, which is an alternate route you can take, and you can get to the blacksmith down here. He smashes through the wall for you with a pickaxe, and right outside that wall is this section. I was like, la 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 la, boom! Just got ambushed from all sides by the bone wolves. It was horrible. It was absolutely horrible. Scared the crap out of me. So anyway, the way you get to Vamos, you may remember in last episode, I mentioned that I was surprised that some of the skeletons were dying because we hadn't killed the necromancer. There was like a spiral staircase with a big hole in the middle. The reason for that was because their necromancer had actually fallen down that hole and killed himself, and if you go down that hole, there's a couple of platforms you can land on at the sides, and you can make your way down safely, and then at the very bottom, that's when you drop into the section with Vamos. Yeah, there will be a cutscene, he'll open the wall, and then you're out by the bonewheel skeleton, so bear that in mind. You will be smack bang in the middle, and it will be very, very dangerous. You want to use that doorway to your advantage. Okay, so we are about to take on PINWHEEL, the first boss of the catacombs here. And I'm going to try and one-shot him. I don't know if this will work, but we are going to try it. Yeah. Kirby! Okay, so this is Pinwheel, and as I've mentioned, this guy is notoriously easy. He's still dangerous when he hits you, but, God damn it, stop shooting me, I already killed you, you cheating son of a bitch. There we go, we just one-shot Pinwheel. That's why he's notoriously easy. Incredibly low HP. And there we go, we get the mask of the child. When you kill him, you'll get a random mask, either the child, the mother, or the father. The mother boosts your HP by a little bit, the child boosts your stamina recovery by a little bit, and the father boosts your equipment load by a little bit. I think the child's my favorite one, because who needs freaking HP or equipment load, but yeah. Also, it looks badass, because it looks a bit like Michael Myers, and I mean the guy from Halloween, not the actor, but with kind of crazy hair. I like it. Oh, and if you want the other masks, there's two other ways to get them. You can either farm the little pinwheel guys, which frankly are probably exactly as strong as the big one, but with less HP. They are just outside of Nito's boss room, and they respawn, and you can get the mask from them. Or, if you save Patches and don't kill him, we're about to see him now, you can buy the other masks from him later. I think they're like 2,000 each, not a whole hell of a lot. Boom, son. Oh god, I've missed you, Legend of Zelda Sword. You are freaking amazing. Okay, so, this section incredibly dangerous, mostly because we can't see shit, Captain. Oh, and that big lavery section down there, that's the Demon Ruins, just to the right of that, that's where we took out Ceaseless Discharge. I really love the fact that you can see that from up here, that's freaking badass. Also, you can actually see the Ash Lake from just outside of Nito's boss room, well, kind of a walkway to his boss room. I'll show you later, it's freaking awesome. Okay, so if you hear that noise in the background, that's giant skeleton buddies with ginormous freaking arrows trying to hit me. So yeah, you can see them right there. They are like bloody javelins. If you get hit by those things, the knockback is insane. It will probably knock you off the side, oh shit! Oh, come on! What the hell? God damn it. I really suck at that. Okay, so I guess I gotta run back there again. Well, shit. Okay, we are back, and somehow I did not die to the bone wheels the second time either. Holy shit, this time. Don't roll in here, there's not enough room for that. Why am I so bad with gravity? I swear to God, I genuinely think I've died more times to gravity in this game than I have actual enemies. It's insane. Oh, holy shit. Okay, so where the hell do we go now? I always get lost at this section. We don't go that way. Do not go near the giant arrows. Here we go. Anyway, I should probably point out that we're not technically in the catacombs anymore. This is the Tomb of the Giants. After you beat Pinwheel, that's where the Tomb of the Giants begins. So, yeah, even though it's not really a huge transition, I can't say that freaking word. Transition, it just gets really dark. It's still the Tomb of the Giants, and yeah, it sucks. A lot. Okay, anyway, I'm gonna kill all this bad boy, repair all my busted ass equipment, and then do some leveling up, and then we will be ready. Okay, let's go. Time for probably my least favorite area of the game, just because A, it's dark as shit and you can't see what you're doing, and B, because of that, I get my ass whooped all of the goddamn time down here. I really hate the Tomb of the Giants.
Good day. You look reasonably sane. What are you doing in the catacombs? Are you a cleric or something?
Okay, so if you want to keep Patches alive and get him as a merchant, say no here.
No? Really? Then I'd have no qualms telling you. There's a fine stash of treasure right down that hole. I found it first, but, well, we're friends now. So I'll split it with you. In any case, have a look. It'll shimmer you blind.
Oh, you. You suspicious man.
This is what I do, my friend. The trinkets I'll be stripping off your corpse, that's the real treasure.
Okay, let's be honest here. Who the hell didn't see that one coming? And like I say, if you tell me you're a cleric or not, it doesn't matter. Either way, he kicks you into the pit. So yeah, we are going back to have a word with him. And also, look who we found.
Oh, no hollow, are you? Thank goodness. Please be careful. There are two fierce hollows not far from here. They were once brave knights, my former escorts. Who would let such strong spirits be hollowed so? Heavens, is there nothing at all to be done?
Okay, so in other words, the two guys that were escorting her down here to protect her have lost their minds and gone hollow, because apparently they're real shitty at what they do. And my god, we turn to a giant skull down here. That's freaking badass on so many levels. Okay, that guy's dead. You've died to a skull, sir. I want you to know that. Ouch! You freaking dick. Oh my god, I was trying to power you. Why am I You stop it. That's a very bad Vince and or Nico. Whatever the hell your damn name is. Okay, they are dead. Let's go back and have a chat with her. I did it.
You banished those two hollows, did you? It pains me to think of the trouble my failings have caused. I am certain that both Vince and Nico are grateful to you. Thank you so very much. Here, these belonged to them. You deserve them more than I.
Lady, trust me when I say it was my freaking pleasure. Okay, so she will find her way out of here. I don't know how the hell she does that, considering she barely got in here with bodyguards, but, whatever, we'll overlook that. So, she will show up at the altar in the Undead Parish, back where we killed the Bell Gargoyles. You may remember there was a bonfire keeper soul on an altar next to a statue, and there was a giant Baron Ignite there. That is where she will be. She will be praying there. However, if you don't go and speak to her quick enough, she will get killed. Not gonna spoil it by who, but, yes. You want to do that, and she'll give you, I think, Wrath of Gods, which is the cheapest goddamn spell in the entire game. I can't stand it. It's basically a giant explosion, it does tons of freaking damage, it's almost unavoidable, and everyone likes to spam the shit out of that in PvP. God, I hate Wrath of Gods so damn much. Okay, oh shit! I forgot there was a ledge there, almost went right off of that. Okay, so anyway, down here there is another Ember, I don't remember which one it is, but screw it, we're gonna go grab it. And this is one of the most dangerous rooms in the entire game, in my opinion. There's like four or five of the giant skeletons, and they don't freaking mess around, and it's pitch black down there, so, yeah. Lunging attack! Did I kill both of them? Yes, I did. Well, alrighty then, okay. Take this guy out, then we should be okay here. Boom, son! Oh, god, I love this sword so much. So freaking much. Okay, I think there's just one more. No, there's two. Well, shit. Yeah, nice try, buddy. Nice freaking try. Now you got a taste of the Sword of Justice. Yeah, get out of here. There's also a petrified blacksmith down here. Again, I don't know why they're petrified, because some people speculate that the other one was petrified somehow by the Moonlight Butterfly. Maybe it's a kind of cocoon or something, but doesn't explain this guy. Don't know what's up with that. Ain't got a goddamn clue. Wait a second. I just noticed bones shit all over the walls. I've never noticed that before. I mean, don't get me wrong. We're in the Tomb of the Giants. There's skeletons everywhere, but maybe this actual room is like a tomb or something. So it looks like maybe he set up his blacksmith place in a tomb, and then maybe the skeletons came to life and murdered him horribly, I don't know, but, yeah, blacksmiths, not the sharpest tools in the shed, like, Peter Andre setting his shop up next to a freaking Titanite demon, and the one next to the Moonlight Butterfly. God damn it, these guys are complete morons. Anyway, we are back up where Patches boot us off. Where the hell are you, you son of a bitch? What's up, buddy? Remember me?
Oh, you, I, well... Let's just calm down. Talk about things. I did you wrong, but I didn't mean it. These temptations, they can, well, overcome me. You know what I mean, don't you? Please, forgive me. You and me, we're jolly undead outcasts, aren't we?
Yeah, you can suck on my balls.
For heaven's sake, let's not mope about, eh? You're still alive. I said I'm sorry. Wait, I know. Here, take this. It proves something, doesn't it?
Okay, steady on there, creepo. So if you say no, he'll give you the twin humanities, but I don't like this guy. Boom! I'm sorry, buddy. The temptation, it just overcome me. You know how it is. Oh, wait, you're dead. Fuck you, Patches. Yeah, let's get the hell out of here. Good lord, I enjoyed that. That was cathartic as hell. So anyway, yes, if you don't kill him, he'll show back up in Phylex Shrine. He's basically at the top of the stairs which leads down to the graveyard, which is the way we got here. So, yeah, you can buy some good shit off of him. It's mostly, basically Vince and Nico's armor and weapons. You can also buy the masks, as I mentioned, and there's a few other things. Frankly, I don't remember what they are, but I don't think they're too important. But, yeah, pretty damn decent merchant, like I say. Only way, as far as I know, that you can actually get Vince and Nico's gear. At least I think so. Okay, so if this is the section that I'm thinking of, this is where we meet a new enemy, which are, like, giant, yes, giant dog things. They're not really a dog, but you know what I mean, they're like bipedal skeleton dudes, and, they are are, in my opinion, one of, easily, the most- Oh, shit! Okay, you scared the crap out of me, dude! Don't freaking do that! Yeah, backstab of justice anyway! Those bipedal skeleton- Stop it! Okay, that guy's dead. We are gonna be fine. Anyway, the bipedal skeleton guys, incredibly dangerous, and I'm not exaggerating when I say that. They have a charge attack where they'll just sort of ram the head from side to side very, very quickly. It will basically kill you outright if you take the brunt of it, and it can destroy your stamina as well. So if you want to block that, you need a very, very good shield. So, yeah, those guys not to be messed with. Okay, so we can get the covetous silver serpent ring around here. I believe it's just where I picked up that soul consumable. You just walk off the edge into the freaking darkness and hope that you land on the platform. I'm gonna try and get it, but I warn you, I have done this before, but frankly, I don't see shit down there. So, yeah. Okay, thank God for that. This is only the second time I've ever done this. Now, I know when we pick up the ring, we're gonna get ambushed. I can't remember by what, though. Oh, these guys. Well, that ain't good. They are incredibly dangerous. They have a sort of flailing arm attack. Trust me, it's really, really powerful. You don't want to get hit by that. Plus, they could probably just knock us off the side. Okay. They are dead, and there's our ring. So what? The ring does the same thing as the covetous gold serpent ring does, except not for items. It does it for souls. So I think you get either double or 50% extra souls when you kill an enemy with the ring equipped. Not entirely sure. How the hell do we get out of here? I think we have to jump across that gap. Oh, God. Let's go for it. And, oh, God, I'm scared. Right, I want to kill this guy first. Can I free aim him? Well, it was very, very close. Okay, screw it. Let's go. Okay, we're fine. Okay, that was scary. Don't do that. Oh, shit, there's a giant dog body there. Okay, he's fine. And, oh, son. Is that going to one-shot him? Yes, it did. Thank Christ for that. I do not want to fight those guys. Trust me. I've died to them so many times. This is one of the areas in the game that made me rage really hard in my first playthrough because I was getting absolutely destroyed by those dudes. Like, really, really destroyed. That section with the Black Knights and the Dog Dudes, I died there maybe 10 or 15 times. It was ridiculous. Mostly because the Black Knight would not leave me the fuck alone. God, I hate that guy. Okay, he is dead, and you should be too. We do have some repair powder if we need it, but our weapon, still okay at the moment. Okay, there's another one here. Now, I doubt these guys have got anything. You could just hug the right wall and go down to NITO, but, I want to check over here, dammit. There's nothing here, is there? Okay, don't go that way. Okay, so if you look over there where that blue stuff is, that's the ash lake that I mentioned. That's where the giant arch trees are. I love that. I love the sort of thing that you can play through the game a bunch of times and you may never notice it. It's just very subtle, but when you do notice it, it's kind of freaking amazing. Like, when I noticed when I was going across the bridge to Sif, I noticed that that was the bridge in the DLC. I was like, holy shit! That's freaking amazing, because it's so subtle, and yet you just somehow don't notice it until one day it's just like, it clicks, and you realize it's freaking awesome. So yeah, check that shit out. Now you can't see the actual ash lake from here, at least I don't think so. It's kind of the same area with the arch trees and the weird blue misty shit down there. Looks awesome, I love that place. Okay, so we are almost at NITO. There is no more bonfires between us and him, so I'm gonna try and conserve my best spells at least a little bit. We need at least a few dark beasts to try and take out NITO quickly, because that guy, if you let him get offense in, he's kind of ginormous and tends to miss you, but when he does hit, it hurts like a motherfucker. Speaking of people that hurt like motherfuckers, this is Paladin Leroy Jenkins, and this guy hits like a truck. No, 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 no. That's a very bad Paladin Leroy Jenkins. You get out of here. So now he's dead, we will get the Grant and the Sanctus, his weapon and shield, which, you know, they are basically faith weapons, so we can't really do anything good with those, but still, I like collecting shit. There we go. Okay, so I believe that's the very last invasion in the game, as far as NPCs go, and unless I'm mistaken, I don't think we've actually been invaded by a single player, which is freaking insane to me. Like, holy shit. What is up with the connections on this game? I can't even summon anyone. I think we summoned one person, might have been two, but, I think it was just one. I know we summoned someone for, Quaalug, and he died almost instantly in comical fashion to an explosion, which was awesome. But that was the only guy, as far as I remember, that we've actually managed to summon. And nobody has invaded us. Ouch! Look at a giant arrow sticking out my ass. Holy shit. It's going through the other side. That looks very silly. Oh, shit! Okay, usually I run past these guys. Don't go off the edge. Okay, we're nearly dead. This is why I normally run past them, because they are very, very dangerous in this tight little section. Okay, the bony guy's coming along. We ready to kill you quickly? Okay, he's dead. The archer nowhere near as bad. Although he still hurts, though. Okay, will you stop shooting me? I just want to kill you, goddammit. Thank you. Okay, so these weird bum piles, they can drop white titanite slabs rarely, I think. And I know they drop wet sand at chunks, at least, you know, reasonably commonly. So, yeah, if you want to farm those, that's what you gotta kill. I'm pretty sure they drop slabs anyway, but I don't think I've ever had one, because, like every slab in the game, they are gonna be incredibly rare. Speaking of wet slabs, I believe there's one wet slab in this room, as well as two souls of a hero. I think that's all of the booty. And there is, the mini pinwheel dudes down here. Again, they don't have anywhere near as much HP, not that he had much in the first place, but they do hit very, very hard. And yes, there are tiny little baby skeletons that cause you to be, I think that's toxic. It might be poison, not entirely sure, but, yeah, they infinite respawn here. You kill them, they'll just rise back up out of the ground, not instantly, but, they do come back pretty quickly. They drop humanity at a reasonable rate, and they don't give terrible souls, so it's one of those areas in the game that a lot of people farm at. Personally, I've never done it, but yeah, it's pretty good for souls and humanity, but not great for either. Kind of a good balance. Wait a minute, what the hell? What's a baby skeleton? Okay, I thought the pinwheel guy had died or something. I was very confused there for a second. So anyway, yeah, I don't remember exactly how to get to the white slab in here. I know you have to kind of drop down or go into a hole or something. I don't remember exactly where the hell you get it, but I know it's around here somewhere, dammit. Where the hell are you? Give me a moment here to try and find it, because otherwise, it might waste a whole lot of time. Ah, there you are. You can't hide from me. Well, I guess you can, because I couldn't find you for a minute or two there. Okay, so anyway, there we go. There's our white slab. Not that I'm ever going to use the damn thing, but still. I just wanted to show it on camera, because I think I forgot to do that in my soul level 1 run. Alright, let's get the hell out of here. Beep, beep. Man on a mission coming through. I'm gonna go kill your boss. Or your father, whatever the hell he is, because, yeah, a lot of baby skeletons. Maybe Nito's just a player. That's all I'm saying. Okay, and there's our final solo hero. Okay, so how's our weapon doing? Is it repaired now? Yes, it is. Okay, it's time to take on Nito. Like I say, we kind of need the club on for this, but I don't want to get rid of the catalyst, so I guess we'll get rid of the sword for now, and we'll just go with the catalyst and the club. Where the hell is the club? Good lord, I have way too many freaking weapons, like, holy shit. Okay, the really bad thing about this boss fight, besides the skeletons that keep reviving, is the fact that when you fall down here, you take a shitload of fall damage. God, it sucks. Okay, let's dance, baby. Now, I really like the art design on Nito, because if you look very carefully, he's got one kind of bigger skull at the top, and then he's just made out of bodies besides that. Plus, his sword, freaking badass. That's like a big version of the Gravelord sword, Jump Attack, that we got from joining his covenants. But, yeah, it's really weird to me that you can come and join his covenants. He's okay with you being here, but you come down this way, he's like, no, fuck you, get out of my lair. Okay, those guys are dead. Let's see if we can very quickly switch to the sword. Or, you know, I can completely fumble. Don't hit me. Start swinging at me. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. That was very close. Okay, it's Dank the son of a bitch. Holy Christ. We might four shot him. Can we do it in four shots? I think we can. Boom. Suck on that. There we go. Nito is down. Five shots to kill both bosses combined. That is the power of freaking sorcery and the power of love and death. Mostly death. There we go, we get our final Lord Soul, so all we have left to do, besides the Drake that I want to one-shot on the bridge, is the final boss. So, next episode will be the final episode. Oh, by the way, you can get Paladin Leroy Jenkins' armor in here. Assuming you killed him, you need some kind of a load screen, just like Lortrex in the Xanthus gear. Log out and back in, or warp with the bonfire, come back again, then his armor will be in the corner. So anyway, I'm gonna end it here. Thanks for watching, guys, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, I would appreciate a like, and I'll see you next time for the final episode of Dark Souls.